please say this to Facebook and Twitter?
We spoke a different language on the plane, and now we're getting kicked out.
That's insane.
Now we're getting kicked out. We're getting kicked out because we spoke a different language. This is 2016.
Crazy.
2016. Look, Delta Airlines are kicking us out because we spoke a different language. Because we spoke a different language. Thank you so much. You guys are racist. I cannot believe my eyes. I cannot believe it. I spoke a word, a different language, and you said you feel uncomfortable because I spoke a different language. I can't believe it. I can't believe my eyes.
Why are you guys doing that?
Because we spoke a different language.
That is so upsetting.
And you guys, are you serious? I'm about to cry right now, seriously. Because we said a word in a different language, and there's six white people against us bearded men. Six white people against us bearded men. How about you kick them out? I feel uncomfortable. No, you're going to kick us out once we go outside. That's what's going to happen. They're going to kick us out. Delta Airlines. And I have an account with you guys, too. I spoke a different language and they're kicking us out. Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you so
much.
Thank you so much, man.
Why are those white people complaining about these people speaking in a different
language? Thank you. I appreciate it.
I am upset that that's happening. Really upset.
Thank you so much. You should kick them out. They cursed us out. He told me shut the fuck up. We never cursed. He told me to shut the F up.
Hey
guys, I'm Adam Soller.
What's up? I'm Slim.
And today we're going to talk to you guys about what happened at the Delta airplane we're at. So right now we're in New York City. We finally made it home safe. And I just want to say thank you guys so, so much for your support. Seriously, you guys have been helping us so, so much. And what happened today, seriously, breaks my heart. Our flight was around 10:10 a.m. in the morning. We're heading back to New York City. We haven't been home for a month and a half, so we're tired, ready to go home. I speak to my mom on the phone for around 10, 20 seconds till it's gonna be a 6-hour flight. I close it. I start speaking to Slim in Arabic, and this is where the issue, I guess, where people had an issue. When me and him were speaking Arabic, there was this lady 4 seats in front of us. She looks back and she says, "Can you please speak English? I feel really uncomfortable." And then me and Slim were just shocked. He was just so paralyzed.
I was frozen, to be honest, because she was speaking directly to me, and I didn't know what to say to that, because I felt like really weird, to be honest. And then Adam stood up for me.
I spoke to her. I told her, I was like, "Haven't you heard anyone speak a different language?" And then another lady who was from Pakistan, who was sitting a few seats away from us, she stood up and she was like, "This is very stereotypical. I speak Urdu and they would just speak in Arabic. What you're doing is wrong. They can speak whatever language they want." Then a man who was traveling with the lady, I do not know if that was her husband or I don't know who he was, her brother, he got up and he literally said, "Chuck them off the effing plane. Chuck them off the plane." And that just caused like a whole
chain reaction.
Like a whole chain reaction. Like 20 of them got up saying, "Get out, get out. Oh my God." His fists are up in the air. And me and Sim were looking at each other like, all we did is speak Arabic.
I felt really uncomfortable that people were just like looking at us and pointing at us and screaming at us. I didn't say a word the whole time because I was just that afraid, scared and stuff. And Adam was the only one like actually talking, defending us.
And then they even went to the flight attendants first of Delta. This is the exact words from the flight attendants. They looked at the passengers. They were like, "If you feel uncomfortable for them speaking Arabic, then you leave the plane." Then they all went insane. It was like 20 of them. They were like, "Where's the captain? Where's the captain?" The captain came and the captain tries to speak to us. We couldn't even speak to the captain because these people were literally going crazy. And then the lady that was next to us, God bless her, she told the captain that all we did was speak Arabic. But since the captain saw everyone against us and telling us, "Oh my God, they don't feel comfortable. Stuff went on in Germany last time. I'm so scared. I didn't even know what happened in Germany. I haven't been watching the news. Me and him have been traveling everywhere." And then this other lady was telling the captain, they had their fists up and they were speaking Arabic harshly. When you speak Arabic, any foreigner, they know when they speak Arabic, there's hand movements that we speak. We're laughing. We cannot laugh and speak Arabic. So then the captain comes up to us and he tells us, "Can I have a word with you guys outside?" I said, "Okay." He said, "Okay." And then he tells us, "But bring your bags." At that moment, that's when we knew we're being kicked out. And that's when other passengers stood up and they were like, "This is freedom of speech, what we had. And this is wrong for kicking us off the plane for speaking another language." And then at the moment when I was filming and saying that they're kicking us out for speaking another language, Delta did not say anything. No one stood up. No one in the whole plane said anything about it. They stood quiet when I said they're kicking us out for speaking another language. Once we got out the plane, they told us, "Don't worry, we can accommodate you with another flight." But we felt like, how are you gonna just kick us off and accommodate us with another flight to make us feel better. We didn't do anything. If anything, why don't you kick the other people out who felt uncomfortable around us?
I was still paralyzed and I was still frozen, and security's escorting us out like we did. We committed a huge crime.
They sit us down back to our gate and they tell us, oh, don't worry, we're gonna give you guys another flight. And I'm trying to speak to them. I'm like, if anything, why didn't you kick out the people that cursed us? We never cursed anyone. So then we're sitting down at the gate. There was a couple people who worked with Delta that came up to us. They told us, like, do not let this go. Delta has done this many times in the past. And when that Delta worker was talking to us, another Delta worker who was against us, he went to that worker and he told him to get off, to get away from us and not to speak to us. And then after that, they bring the police on us, the UK police. They come up to us, they speak to us. They were very, very nice. We tell them the situation and they were shocked. They saw the video. They told us, keep the video, do not remove the video. And if I was you, make a complaint and let everyone know out there. It's really sad because this issue can happen to anyone. It can happen to elderly people who can't even speak English, and they'll be helpless. They'll have nothing to do. They won't even know how to use a camera, don't know how to use a phone to even reach out to anyone. So we're spreading this message to you guys to not let it happen again.
It's an issue that people keep using the fact that we're pranksters against us. They keep trying to use our past against us. I feel like this is the boy who cried wolf.
You can see in the video, it's as real as it gets. You see reality clearly in the video.
Another issue is kind of bothering me is that I was the cause of everything. This all happened because of me. And I couldn't speak up for myself, and Adam spoke up for me. He was there for me to speak up. I couldn't speak up for myself. So imagine someone else who couldn't be able to speak up for themselves, you know? So this whole thing's about me, and everybody, all these news outlets are using Adam's face and his past against him. And this is my issue. This is about me. I was the one that was speaking, and they came at me. And Adam's the one defending me because I couldn't speak up for myself. So if you guys can't stop trying to use his past against him. It's because this is about me.
And you can clearly see, there's a video on Slim's channel that he's gonna post. You can clearly see all the workers were literally so rude. So the media is gonna keep twisting our words, but we're not gonna speak to any media right now until we see our attorney, and then we're gonna see what to do from there. I just wanna thank every single one of you guys for all your love and support. You guys truly helped out so, so much.
Thank you so much, for real. I don't even know what to say.
I appreciate every single one of you guys, and thank you guys so, so much.